This has turned into one of my favorite games of all time. And I finally got it running. That's right. Dragon Quest VII. The 3DS version. Get going with this. Yeah, I have played quite a bit of this game already, this emulator, and runs pretty good. The 3DS emulation has definitely become a lot more viable. One thing I do need to mention, though, in this playthrough, I'm going to be banning all the master classes. Reason, they're way too powerful. Plus, I want to challenge myself a little bit, and I have a little bit of a... I see the characters as certain classes, so I'm going to try to play them as such, based on their character. And yeah, I am playing this on an emulator, so the graphics might look a little upscaled here. And yeah, there's going to be like some weird line in the dialogue boxes there. But that's no big deal. It doesn't bother me. But that isn't normal. You won't see that at the native resolution. But yeah, this game is fantastic, man. One of my favorites. This has become one of my favorite games. No, I'm not going to tell you what's going on. I don't even know what you're asking me about, but... Yeah. So yeah, this first town here is called Pilchard Bay. It's called Fishbowl on the PlayStation version. And, if you can see the mouse cursor, you follow over here. I got the bottom screen over here in the bottom right-hand corner. So, in order for you to actually see it, you probably want to make the video full screen. I imagine most people watching probably do that anyways nowadays. Basically, it just gives you map data and, you know, all the other data. But I want the top screen to be the prominent screen being featured, so... Anyway, let's go inside our house. And I'm not going to bother with the treasure that we could be getting at this point, but my mommy is sleeping. Yeah, this character's name is Pearl. She was called Molly in the PlayStation version. And this is my dad, Pollock. He was called Borkino in the PlayStation version. I don't know, I guess some of the new names for the characters are okay. Well, for the side characters anyways. Yeah, let's go ahead and go to sleep. Alright, so my dad has went over to meet the mayor. And yeah, you can do party talk, obviously. If you have party members, that is. And we get a leather hat. Let me go ahead and equip that. And we get 110 gold, which is, I guess, our life savings. That's actually quite a lot of money for this point in the game. So I gotta deliver a sandwich to my dad. We can do that. Can also break pots. Now, with this emulator, there is gonna be some slowdown in the menu, but it's nothing game breaking, and pretty much the rest of the game runs full speed all the time, so that's good enough in my opinion. So I'm gonna post videos of it, and yeah, I love this game, man. It's amazing. But yeah, these pilchard sandwiches, oh no, not that one. We'll get like other pilchard items like fish bits and stuff like that you can use to restore HP. And we're hearing the festival theme. Yeah. And this guy sells pilchard pie. I could buy this, but I'm not gonna bother. I need my gold for other things. Sure, I wanna be a fisherman. I gotta follow my dad's footsteps, you know what I mean? Come back in one piece. One thing I still haven't figured out in this remake, that chest right there in the PlayStation 1 version, you can't open it. So if I wonder if they fixed that or changed it. But yeah, even with the ultimate key, you cannot open that chest in the PlayStation 1 version. So I guess we'll find out eventually, right? I guess if you do know if you can open that chest, drop it in the comments section. I would like to know. That you want to break every barrel and pot and crate that you see. You might have items you can use. All right. See the resilience that will boost your resilience stat between 1 and 3 when you use it on a character. It's going to save them for pretty much end game. I'll be using them on certain characters I deem it necessary. Gold. Yeah, I don't know why somebody stashed 10 gold up here on top of that church, but whatever, I'll take it. Well, I guess they're not gonna let me leave town. Oh well. Yeah, the good thing about this version of the game is they'll actually show you which doors you've opened recently, so you can kind of, it's easier to keep track of which buildings you've been in, because, you know, sometimes that's kind of a pain in the ass when you're trying to loot and get all the possible treasure in new areas that you get to. Gold. And yeah, this is the mayor's wife, Maribel's mother. Yeah, Maribel, she is spirited. Very spirited. Actually, rebellious is a better word to use. Not home, huh? Yeah, you can use the, I probably should have mentioned this before, but you can use the L and R shoulder buttons to pan the camera around, just like you could in the PlayStation version. And 2 gold. Man. Good grief. Give me a little bit more than that, game. Come on, man. Yeah, this game is kind of stingy with the gold. Well, in the beginning, anyways. Yeah, if you examine the mirror, you get different dialogue. Some of it's kind of funny. And we get a hairband. All right, we're going to be saving that for somebody later on. Yeah, this fella. Man, this guy is... Oh, okay, he's got a cold. Bummer, man. Just because you got a cold doesn't mean you can't go out to sea, right? That don't make no sense. Shit, man, a cold can pass in like 2 or 3 days. Thank you. No, I suppose I probably don't want it. Other people getting sick, though. Yummy. Oh man, I got a long way to go. I mean, look at my dad, man. Look how ripped he is. Kind of a runt compared to him. Oh, shit, I'm like half his height. I'm just scrawny, man. Cypress stick. I don't think you could actually find one of these here in the PlayStation version, if I remember correctly. I think you can find one in the village of Estar, which we'll be going to pretty soon. But yeah, I think that and the Wayfarer's clothes, I don't remember them being here in the original PlayStation 1 version. Yeah, don't bother buying gear at this point. It's a waste of money. Save your gold for later. We're going to be coming across a lot of shops in the early going here, but yeah, none of the stuff there is worth spending your coin on. Yeah, we're going to ignore her for now, but yeah, you can see Maribel hiding over there. Doesn't look like she's having too much fun stowing away. Hey, Cook. Yeah, you don't look like you've done a day's work in your life. Well, you're right about that. Culinary skills. Well, thanks, man. I don't know if I'm cut out for that kind of stuff. Yeah, my uncle. I know all about my uncle. My uncle is kind of a shady dude. Alright, we get a Chimera Wing. This will allow you to warp to previously visited towns. And mostly towns. And some other locations. Hey girl, what's up? What you doing over here, huh? Oh, too late. I already blew your cover. Flattery will get you nowhere, young lady. Oh, he wants me to peel potatoes? Well, I suppose that's better than scrubbing a fucking urinal with a toothbrush. And yes, I have done that. So anyway, about those potatoes. Oh, wait, you're already done? Wow, man, you're quick. That's some quick peeling. I'm more of a burden than anything for some reason. I mean, he could just keep me around and swab the deck, but whatever. Man, I gotta look after the old girl. This is a beautiful game. I just love the way it looks. And it's a shame that, you know, people actually playing this on the 3DS guy. I played it in, like, crappy, like, I forgot the resolution, but it's pretty fucking, it's pretty low. Hey, soldier guy. What's going on? Okay, gotta go to the castle. What do you want? No, that's not okay. Alright, fine. So yeah, she forces herself into the party. Yeah, any idiot knows that, of course. My dad's a fisherman. He promised to bring me back loads and loads of fish. Can't wait. Hey, hey, hey. Yeah, she's yelling at me for talking to people. It's not very nice. I don't even want you with me right now. Can I just go there by myself? Oh, so you're gonna be nice to my mom, huh? Yeah, if only you knew, Mom. Yes, she did. Prince Kiefer, eh? Oh, yeah, Kiefer, that guy, huh? Why wouldn't he like fish bits? I mean, I imagine a lot of the castle are You know, people in royalty eat that stuff. I mean, what else are they going to eat? Yeah, you can buy stuff from this guy. Again, don't waste your money. And yeah, I think I better save here. If that's even possible at this point. Yeah, I don't want to be like my uncle. Alright, so in churches, yeah, you can do divination to see how much experience you need to go up a level. Resurrect party members, cure them of poison, cure them of curses, and of course you can save your game. Unfortunately, this emulator that I'm using right now does not have save states. So that kind of sucks in a way, but I'll make do. Alright, did some messing around with the volume there. I was thinking maybe the music was just a little too loud. Drowning out the commentary, don't want that. Anyway. Not so secret. We haven't told you anything about it. Oh, you're gonna tell your dad. Guess what? I don't care. She's telling you about the map controls. You can use the Y button to switch to the world map, and then just toggle to the local map. So, let's go back and Fishbell real quick here. Yeah, any idiot knows that. Let's go talk to your parents. Forgot about that. See what they have to say to you. You figured me out. Where's your dad at? Is he in there? Oh, I don't see him in there. Oh, wait, he's gone. Duh. See, I'm so used to later on in the game coming up here to talk to her dad that, forgot he went out to sea. Anyway. Yeah, I think I've gotten most everything here in town. Yeah, she's got the wrong idea about us. We got like a love-hate relationship going on here. We can talk to these people in here. No more characters lost in thought, like in the original. I kind of miss that in a way. Don't think of, I can't take any detours? What's the fun in that, man? Let's do some sightseeing. I guess we can't get in there right now. Thank you. Yeah, Maribel's running animation is pretty funny too. But yeah, this is a world map. Later on, there'll be enemies that you can run into. You can see all the encounters, which is pretty cool. The only time that you have fixed random encounters in this game is out at sea. Oh, yeah, we're supposed to get an S-star. My bad. Come on, man. And I don't think we can go over here yet either. Or we can, it's just I won't be able to because, yeah, she won't let me. She's just gonna bitch at you the entire time unless you take her to the town, so let's do it. Town Estard. Yeah, there is more fish in the sea. Although, we're only one island, there's probably not that many fish, to be honest. Anyway, let's explore. Let's go on the inn first. Oh, innkeeper. Yes, unfortunately. Uh-oh. Uncle's racking up a bar tab. No, no. Young people should definitely question their elders, because their elders might be wrong. So that's terrible advice. I mean, sure, you can probably get wisdom from old people, and you can probably get stupidity from old people. It all depends. And yeah, another cypress stick. Be giving that to another party member later. So yeah, at this beginning portion of the game, we're going to be fighting with sticks. I mean, we're kids. We don't know how to fight yet, right? Yeah, this island is very peaceful. Which really threw me off when I originally played this game. Because I was like, when do you fight? So I stopped playing. If I would have just kept playing, which is what I should have done, that would have been treated to a great RPG back when I originally tried it. But I didn't do that. I was stupid. But, yeah, a lot of the puzzles in this beginning part of the game has actually been altered in this remake here, which may or may not be bad depending on your preference. I don't mind the puzzles in the original, to be honest. I did when I originally played the game, because back then I was a little bit more impatient. Okay, so yeah, these old people, they're just going to give me terrible advice. Oh, it's the only island in the world. Or is it? This door is firmly locked. These iron gate doors, you need the ultimate key to unlock, which you get at the end of the game. So, yeah, we won't be getting that for a very long time. This is one of the longest RPGs, but a lot of people say that that is a weakness. I don't know. I look at it as a strength. Ton of content. But yeah, there's a lot of good quality of life improvements to this remake. Which I will try to point out as we go here. Hey, old man. Guy's kind of a jerk. Intimidatingly thick books. But yeah, that's Dermot the Hermit. I forgot his name in the PlayStation version, but later on that guy's going to be kind of funny. Yeah, when I first saw this remake and I heard the orchestrated soundtrack, I knew I had to play it. Sadly, they removed the symphonic score from the European and American releases. However, if you go online and search for the ROM and music restoration, you can find ROMs where people actually hacked the original music back in, which is what I did. Yeah, this lady is not going to let us go into the well. You can get a tiny medal or a mini medal in that well, but yeah, that lady is not going to let us in there right now. And yeah, if you talk to people from behind the counter, they'll yell at you sometimes. Shopkeepers will usually have something to tell you or something to say if you do that with them. And we have this fella. And this guy is going to sell stuff that I don't need. And those two chests right there, I think you can unlock them later, but not until much, much later. Guy's name is Pierce, huh? Alright, whatever. You can have her, man. I don't want her. But yeah, general rule of thumb, check everywhere in these games. Yeah, look, Chimera one. I don't typically use those all that much. But yeah, with these chests here, they're locked. They're locked tight. And there's my uncle sleeping away. Let's loot his place. But yeah, this place is a dump. Troublemaker. Some horse manure. Why the hell am I putting that in the bag? I should be throwing that on the ground. But yeah, I still don't know what the hell horse manure does in this game. Can be used as many times as you... I think you can use it to, like, stun enemies or something. I don't know. I never use it. Sad. Bears in the hills. You know, when I first played this remake and they were talking about bears in the hills, I thought they were lying. And actually, I still think they're lying because I didn't find any bears on this island. Me to talk to my uncle. I don't think he's gonna listen to me, buddy. Uh-oh, now he's leaving IOUs. Man. I mean, honestly, that's the shit that my old man used to do to me. Like, when I was a kid, I had like $10 stashed away. My dad actually fucking took the money and left an IOU just like that. I'm not kidding either. I was fucking pissed. I was like, are you serious? You're fucking stealing from your own kid? That's nuts, man. I think I was like, how old was I? I think I was like 10 or 11 years old at the time. But that's the kind of shit that my dad used to do. Alright, so I think we've explored the majority of Eshtard here, and you know what? The castle's up ahead. And I think I'll probably save exploring that for the next video. So yeah, that's all for this episode of Dragon Quest VII, and I love this game. I love it. If you have a 3DS, I highly recommend getting it. If you're like me and you're boycotting Nintendo, I highly recommend downloading it. There's tutorials online on how to use Citra, and quite frankly, depending on your system, you're probably going to need to mess around with the settings a lot to get it to run how you need it to run, but I got it running pretty good here, so See you next time. Bye-bye.